In this video, we're going to be talking about how much you should charge as a freelance developer. If you like this kind of content, make sure to give the video a like and subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification bell so that you will not miss a future episode. So let's jump into this and discuss some of the main points you should be thinking about when deciding what your freelance rate is. So normally, some of the key factors that decide your rate will be your experience. Now, experience is probably one of the biggest factors in determining your freelance rate. So if you are a new developer, then your hourly rate is probably going to be on the lower end. So you may be charging something like $20 an hour, $30 an hour, something like that. And if you are an intermediate developer, then you're probably moving up to like $50 an hour. So we can't just take experience by itself and come up with a rate. We should also be thinking about a few other things, namely where you are from in the world, what country you're living in. So if you are from a market where the average developer, the experienced developer, is maybe somewhere around like $30 an hour, then it's very hard for you to charge $60 or $80 an hour, especially if you are going to be dealing with local clients. Perhaps if you're getting clients from the United States or from Canada or UK, then maybe you can charge a little bit higher. But also you have to understand that if a company or a client is hiring you and they know your location, they will also have some basic expectations of the price range, because they've probably hired other developers from your country before, and they will have an idea of what they would expect to pay for your kind of experience. So aside from your experience and your location, you should also be thinking about what skill set you have and what value that brings to your client. So for example, if you are a PHP developer and you know how to build WordPress websites, for example, there are a lot of WordPress developers out there. So you have to factor in how you compare to the other developers. Why would they pay you twice as much as a different developer who has the same experience? So you got to bear in mind that the skill set that you have and what value it is, or what value you can provide with that skill set, and what makes you stand out in a way. So some of the biggest hourly rates that I've seen are from people that have a very niche skill set. So sometimes that will be things like perhaps they program in a language that nobody uses anymore. For example, something like COBOL, which is, I think it's probably like in the 60s. I think it was around the mid 60s when COBOL was launched. So it's a really old programming language, and a lot of the financial institutions use it even to this day. A lot of the ATMs that we use are running on COBOL. So there are developers out there who specialize in this, even though it's not a skill set that any new developer would be really getting into in these days. So having that niche skill allows you to charge a much higher rate, because it's all about supply and demand. If there's only a handful of developers in the world that can do this work, then they can set the rate that they want to get paid for that work. So when you compare that with being WordPress websites, there might be, you know, $50 million developers out there who build WordPress websites. So you can't really, you don't really have the supply and demand to control the pricing in the same way. So I've also experienced this a few times when I tried to hire developers to do some small pieces of work in niche areas. An example of this is when I tried to get a Magento developer to make a few changes to a plugin that he had built. So Magento being a e-commerce, open source e-commerce platform that runs on PHP. Back in the day, I was building Magento websites, and I don't actually do that anymore, but at this point in time, I was working on several projects, and I'd used this plugin to capture certain values from the checkout, I think. And I just wanted to make a couple of small changes on this to this plugin for a very specific website. But when I got a quote from the original developer of the plugin, I think it was charging something like $450 an hour. So it's really, really high. And in the end, I didn't make those changes, but you know, the salary or the hourly rate can vary a lot depending on what niche product you have. It really comes down to the supply and demand. So in this case, it wouldn't make sense for me to go and get a random PHP developer to go and modify this plugin, because they would be starting from scratch and they would probably spend hours trying to understand what the plugin does. So in this case, it seems to make more sense to probably pay this person the higher amount to do what will take maybe an hour's work or half an hour's work. So you got to factor in what the niche is, what makes this person unique, or what makes you unique as a developer, and how to charge for that. So these are the key things I think that are very important when deciding the cost. But I would say that if you're setting your rate, you should always be leaning a little bit on the high side. And the reason for that is that you will have times where you have to do things for your clients that you can't really charge for, or you may not want to charge for. An example of this is replying to emails, and maybe even doing certain bug fixes on features that you've built previously, and upgrades, maybe even Zoom calls. These kind of things, it's quite difficult to charge for some of them, especially meetings and emails. And really your rate should factor in the time spent doing these things. So that's kind of how I come up with my rate over time. And another point I would say before I close out this video is you should really be considering continually changing your rate over time. And this is something I haven't done that particularly well over the years myself, but I know that it is very important. Every year where you are working and developing your skill set and learning more and doing more work, you are getting better and better at your craft. And as such, you should be charging more per hour, because you can build things faster than you could possibly 3 or 4 years earlier. You can build things at a higher quality than you did previously. So you should be charging reflective of the knowledge you've gained over that period of time. So maybe incrementally increasing your hourly rate each year. And I've seen several people do this. It would increase their rate maybe by $10 each year. And it doesn't sound like that much, but over the course of a year, you will notice the difference. So that's about it for this video. I just wanted to share my thoughts on how to consider your hourly rate as a web developer. Hopefully you guys have found this video helpful. If you have, make sure to like and subscribe to this channel, and I will see you all in the next video.